dear students, how are you all? I wish always be well. In today's video, we are going to discuss about some properties of electromagnetic waves and Maxwell's equation. So under it, first of all, I will tell you the what are the properties of electromagnetic waves. In last video, I have already explained in introduction of electromagnetic waves all these properties, but little bit we will revise for the electromagnetic waves in this video also. Okay, so what are the properties of electromagnetic waves? So you know that electromagnetic waves are produced by accelerating charge. In last video only I have explained that accelerating charge generate electric field, and that the change in electric field always generate the magnetic field. I have explained in last video that accelerating charge generates electric field. This electric field, since electric field is changing, so obviously there would be the magnetic field. Okay, so this change in electric field generates magnetic field, and because of change in because of generation of electric and magnetic field, electromagnetic waves produced. So what are the main, what is the main source of electromagnetic wave? So we call it accelerating charge. Okay, second property is these waves do not require medium to travel. I have already explained that the like sunlight is also a electromagnetic radiation or electromagnetic wave that do not need medium to reach our earth. Okay, because in from sun to earth there is no medium, only near our earth the medium is there, na, air. But without medium it can travel. So electromagnetic waves do not need medium to travel. It can move in free space also. Okay. The next property is these waves are always perpendicular to electric magnetic field. Means the direction of electric field, direction of wave propagation is always perpendicular to the electric and magnetic field. For example, if electric field is at z axis, magnetic field is on y axis, then the direction of propagation will be perpendicular to these two, that is in x direction. And one more method I have told you in last video, that if you will do E cross B, if you will move your hand in form E cross B, then the thumb will show the direction of electric field. So if it is in z axis, it is in y axis, then the thumb is showing the x axis, which means direction of propagation of wave. So it is, the direction of propagation is always perpendicular to electric field and magnetic field. Okay, that's why we call it transverse in nature. That's why the electromagnetic waves are transverse in nature. The last one is in free space the velocity of electromagnetic waves is equals to E0 upon V0, that is equals to velocity of light. Okay, that is 3×10⁸. Okay, so these are the properties of electromagnetic waves. Now we are moving for the Maxwell's equation. So these are the Maxwell equation A.ds. We have already studied about these equations. Like this one is electrostatic law of Gauss law of electrostatics. This one is Gauss law of magnetic field, and so we can use this formula. So let's understand about this one. So this Gauss law of electrostatics tells that electric field, electric flux through any closed surface, that is equals to Q/ε0. Okay, that is, it means that if you are taking the electrostatic field, like one charge, suppose in one charge plus Q is enclosed in a closed surface, then the total flux, total field lines or flux through this closed surface is always equals to Q/ε0. Derivation of it you have studied already in Gauss law of electrostatics, that this value of electric flux, means what? Phi equals to how much you have studied? E.ds. Okay. Integral means overall electric field for a closed surface, that is equals to you have studied by Gauss law, that is Q/ε0. So we can write E.ds integral for equals to Q/ε0. So this is the Maxwell first equation, which is actually Gauss law of electrostatics. Okay, second one is electromagnetic Gauss law of magnetism. It states that integral B.ds equals to 0. It means that since B.ds means flux through a closed surface is always equals to 0. How? Suppose this is the North Pole and field lines are crossing through it. So as we know, there is no single pole do not exist. You have studied.
I will explain here. See, if I will take north, this one, and this one is south. If I will break this magnet, then again this portion will become south. So single pole or monopole do not exist. So if here is north pole, then definitely here is south pole also. If field lines are moving, and we know field lines moves from north pole to south pole, it forms closed loop. So since the number of field lines going outward we take positive, and number of field lines which is coming inwards we take negative. So the number of field lines, how much number of field lines are crossing, moving out of this closed surface which we have considered. So the field lines which are passing, which are moving out of this closed surface, the same number of field lines coming inside of the closed surface. Why? Because the monopole do not exist. So the number and also the magnetic field always form closed loop. Okay, that's why the field lines which are moving out will come to the inward. So that's why the number of field lines which are moving outward definitely will come inward. So the total number of field lines is equals to zero. Okay, for a closed surface. So this is Gauss's second law, Gauss's law of magnetism, which is known as Maxwell's equation, the Maxwell's second equation. Now the third equation is integral B dot dl equals to d phi B by dt. So let's solve it. This one also. You have studied that for a magnet electric field V, dV equals to E dot dl. You have studied E dl. Okay. Now, if you are finding total potential V, that must be equal to integral of E dl. Okay. Now, E is what? It's a EMF or potential. So in case of a magnetic field, the EMF is equals to minus d phi b by dt. You have studied, okay? Minus d phi b by dt. So this both are the same potential, means potential gets, like this electric field is converting to the magnetic field. So that's why we can write this EMF or voltage equals to this EMF. So integral E dot dl equals to minus d phi b by dt. This expression shows that the electric field is converting into magnetic field, and this magnetic field is converting into electric field. By this way the waves are moving. Electric field is converting into magnetic field, electrical energy is converting into magnetic energy, then again magnetic energy is converting into electric energy. Okay, so this is the third expression, and last one is Ampere's modified Ampere's circuital law. Earlier it was, you have studied earlier, that integral B dot dl equals to mu times I conduction. I conduction means the current through any conductor, but this term Maxwell has added for the for general case. He added this one epsilon zero. This is known as displacement current. So mu zero epsilon zero d phi e by dt. We can derive this expression also. How? Let's find out this value. But derivation of it is not in your syllabus for this derivation, because it is known as a displacement current, which has removed from your syllabus this year. But I'll explain. Maxwell did one experiment, and according to experiment he has applied current. So because of change in current, since current is flowing through this circuit, so definitely there will be magnetic field. And by Ampere's law, the integral of BdL, total number of magnetic flux for this closed loop, total number, this is what, this term you have studied in chapter magnetism, electromagnetic induction, maybe in fourth chapter, that is electromagnetic induction. Okay, so in that field you have studied that Ampere's circuital law. What does it states? It states that integral total number of flux is equals to mu times I inside, means total current through this conductor. So I, but
Maxwell did one experiment. In that experiment, he kept he brought a magnetic needle near it, and that compass, magnetic compass, get deflected. That needle get deflected. But so he told that because it is mu zero times I, since current is flowing, so flux is generating. But here in between the parallel plate capacitor, there is no current is flowing through it. So, but here also magnetic needle did get deflected. So what did he say? He said here is no current, so why the magnetic needle is deflecting? So he said, since here the electric field is changing here, because continuously it is charging, the parallel plate capacitor is charging. Charging means the number of charges are changing. So since the number of charges are changing, so obviously the electric field also is changing. So because of change in electric field here, the magnetic field is also generating, and which we consider and that current there, one considerable current we are taking, that is known as this displacement current. Means we are considering that some current is flowing through this circuit from here. Means this, because of increment in electric field, this dielectric field is converted as a conducting path. You have studied about it in second chapter. So this, because of this electric field, we are considering that some current is flowing through it. That current is known as displacement current. So he found the value of that displacement current by finding the this formula. So we have studied, we know that electric field, these are the two parallel plate capacitor. So the electric field between the two parallel plates capacitor, we have studied, it is sigma upon epsilon naught. Okay, and sigma equals to what? Surface charge density, that is Q by A epsilon naught. Now since we are finding flux, so integral E into A means total flux, electric flux. So total electric flux equals to what? So Q upon A epsilon naught into A. So this A cancels. What we got Q upon epsilon naught. Okay, so E into A we got Q upon epsilon naught. Okay, now this is flux. Okay, this is flux, electric flux phi E. Now Q equals to, you can find Q equals to epsilon naught phi E. Okay, now I will differentiate it. So it will be dQ by dt, that is equals to epsilon naught d phi E by dt. And this is what? This dQ by dt is what? He considered this dQ by dt, this current is displacement current, and he wrote up for it ID, displacement current. So this displacement current is epsilon naught d phi E by dt. So he added this term of displacement current for the this area. So he wrote mu naught ID, the displacement current. And this ID, he found this expression, and when he substituted this value, we got this expression. Okay, mu naught epsilon d phi E by dt. Understood? So he modified, Ampere's modified this law of Ampere's circuital law, and gave this law, this equation. Okay, so but derivation will not come in your exam, this derivation, but only you will learn this expression. Okay, that Maxwell's fourth equation is this one. And if numerical will come, you can substitute all those values and can find out the answer. So I hope it is clear to you all. Okay, if you have doubt, you can ask in questions in online classes. Okay, take care all of you. Study well. Take care. Bye-bye.